Mathematics immunization. That's this platform. Last week we started quadratic equations. This is part two for today. And we said that ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to zero is a general form of a quadratic equation, whereby we said that the a is the coefficient of x squared, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. Coefficient means the number in front of the variable or the unknown. That's the coefficient. Methods of solving quadratic equations: factorization method, coupling the square method, quadratic formula method, graphical method. We've done justice to factorization method. Today we are going on completing the square method. Example: solve the following quadratic equations by completing the square method. We have three questions here. We'll take them after the other, one after the other. So we have 4y squared plus 5y minus 21 is equal to 0. Step 1, make the coefficient of y squared to be 1. That is, you divide through by 4 to make here 1. So you have over 4, over 4, everything over 4. So 4 here, 1. So y squared plus 5 over 4y minus 21 over 4 is equal to 0. 0 over 4 is 0. Step 2, transfer the constant term to the right-hand side. Now we have that, don't forget, the constant term here has minus. Take note. So when you transfer here, it becomes plus. When you jump the equality sign, it becomes plus 21 over 4. Now we have the left-hand side and right-hand side. Step 3, add to both sides the square of half of the coefficient of y. What is the coefficient of y? Is 5 over 4. So the square of half of 5 over 4. So 1 times 5 is 5, 2 times 4 is 8, all squared. Add it to left hand side and right hand side. So from the left hand side, we have y squared plus 5 over 4y plus 5 over 8 squared is equals to 21 over 4 plus 5 over 8 all squared. And if you look at this expression here, you have square here, you have square here. This is a perfect square. The perfect square. And so by mental mathematics, you can pick y and 5 over 8. That is having 2. So we have y plus 5 over 8 all square. I'm still going to break this down so you can understand the logistics. So, but from the side, we have 21 over 4 plus 5 squared is 25 and 8 squared is 64. Now, I said I want to explain how this perfect square became this. So, y plus 5 over 8 all square, it means y plus 5 over 8 times y plus 5 over 8. So, y times y will give you y square. Y times 5 over 8 give you 5 over 8y. Plus 5 over 8 times y will give you 5 over 8y. 5 over 8 times 5 over y, you can put it as square. 5 over 8 all squared. So it's equals to y squared plus. You find the LCM here, you have 8. So 8 in 8, 1. 1 times 5y, 5y. Plus 8 in 8, 1. 1 times 5y, 5y. Plus 5 over 8 all squared. So y squared plus 5y plus 5y is 10y over 8 plus 5 over 8 all squared. So 2 in 8 is 4 and 2 in 10 is 5. So you have this. Compare this and this. You can see it's the same. So whenever you have a perfect square, just pick the look at the two terms that have square and square in a perfect square. You pick y and 5 over 8. Assuming you have minus 5 over 8 here, it will become y minus 5 over 8 all squared. How we are getting it. So from that point, we continue. So from this side now, 21 over 4 plus 5 squared is 25 over 64. When you find the LCM, 64, 4 and 64 is 16. 16 times 21. 336 plus 64 here, 1 times 25 is 25. So we have y plus this is equal to this over 64. Step 4, you remove the square, and that is square root of both sides, taking the square root of both sides. So y plus 5 over 8 is equal to square root of 361 over 64. We have plus or minus whenever you have square root, because a quadratic equation has two factors or two roots. So we are going to generate that. For instance, if you have square root of 9, it's going to be plus or minus 3, because plus 3 times plus 3 is plus 9, and minus 3 times minus 3 is also plus 9. So we can generate two roots like that. So y is equal to bring plus 5 over 8 the other way. You have minus 5 over 8 plus or minus. Square root of 361 is 19. Square root of 64 is 8. So when you find the LCM, you have 8, and you have 8 in 8, 1. 1 times this, you have this plus or minus 8 here, 1 times this. So two answers, plus or minus. So y is equal to minus 5 plus 19 over 8, or minus 5 minus 19 over 8. 19 minus 5, that is 14 over 8, or minus 5 minus 19, you are owing, that is minus 24 over 8. And when you break it down, you have 7 over 4 or minus 3. It's an improper fraction. I think to a mixed fraction. Y is equal to this. Good. Example 2, you rearrange the quadratic equation. 2x squared, bring 3x here, becomes minus 3, minus 5 is equal to 0. Step 1, divide through by 2. So we have this over 2 over 2 over 2 and 0 over 2. If you are very smart, since I know that the constant is still coming to this other side, I may not bring it here. So 2 into 1 x squared minus 3 x over 2 minus 5 over 2. 0 over 2 is 0. Step 2, transfer the constant 10. So x squared minus 3 over 2x minus 5 over 2 is coming here, gives you plus 5 over 2. The next step is add the coefficient of x is minus 3 over 2. So add to both sides, that's the left hand and right hand side, the square of half of this coefficient, that is half of minus 3 over 2 all squared. 1 times minus 3 is minus 3, 2 times 2 is 4 all squared. So adding to both sides, x squared minus 3 over 2x plus bracket minus 3 over 4 squared is equal to 5 over 2 plus minus 3 over 4 all squared. So this is also a perfect square, like example 1. So this is x squared and this is minus 3 over 4 squared. We pick these two terms. So this is having minus, that will be x minus 3 over 4 all squared. I hope you are getting that point. X minus 3 over 4 all squared is equal to 5 over 2. Minus 3 squared will give you plus 9 and 4 squared give you 16. So the LCM of this is 16. So 2 in 16 is 8. 8 times 5, 40 plus 16 is 16, 1. 1 times 9, 9. That is 40 plus 9, 49 over 16. So this square root, take the square root of both sides. So x minus 3 over 4 will be plus or minus square root of 49 over 16, which is 7 over 4. So bring minus 3 over 4 here. You have plus 3 over 4. When you find the LCM, you have this. So x will be 3 plus 7 over 4 or 3 minus 7 over 4. This is 10 over 4 or minus 3 minus 7 is minus 4 over 4. And 2 in 4, 2, 2 in 10, 5. 5 over 2 or 4 here minus 1. This is, you don't leave it in improper fraction. That is mixed, change to mixed fraction. 2 and a half or minus 1. Example 3, p squared plus 7p plus 12 is 0. Now the coefficient of p squared is 1. So you just jump step 1. Step 2, you just transfer the constant term, which is 12. When you transfer it, you have minus 12. So next step is add to both sides half of 7. 7 is the coefficient of p, half of that and the square of it, which is 7 times 1, 7 over 2 all squared. So add this to left hand and right hand side. So p squared plus 7p plus 7 over 2 all squared is equal to minus 12 plus 7 over 2 all squared. This is a perfect square. So you pick this p and 7 over 2. So you have p plus 7 over 2 all squared. Take note, when you multiply this twice, you have everything. So it's equal to minus 12 plus 7 squared is 49, 2 squared is 4. Since this is fraction, express minus 12 as fraction, right over 1. The LCM is 4. 1 in 4 is 4. 4 times minus 12 is minus 48 plus 4 in 4, 1. 1 times 49, 49. So 49 minus 48 gives you 1 over 4. So to remove the square here, you take the square root of both sides. So p plus 7 over 2 is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 over 4. And square root of 1 is 1. Square root of 4 is 2. So transfer this here. So plus 7 over 2 becomes minus 7 over 2. Then you find the LCM, you have this. So p is equal to minus 7 plus 1 over 2 or minus 7 minus 1 over 2. So p is equal to minus 6 over 2 or minus 8 over 2. And p is minus 3 or minus 4. I believe it's clear. Now you can be given these roots. These are the roots of the quadratic equation. You can be given these roots and you have to work backward to get the original quadratic equation. So finding the quadratic equation with given roots. The values of the unknown which satisfy the given equation are called the roots of the equation. For instance, if you have factorized this quadratic equation, we have this. And so x is equal to minus 10 or 2. These are the roots of the quadratic equation. So you can be given these roots and you are required to generate the quadratic equation. Now, from x squared plus 8x minus 20 is 0. When you have solved this by a computing square method or by a factorization method, you have this. These are the roots of the equation. So s, you now say let s be minus 10 and s is 2. Bring minus 10 here, you have plus 10. So s plus 10 is 0. Bring 2 here, you have s minus 2 is 0. So s plus 10 is a factor. These are the two factors. When you multiply the two factors, you have your result. So that's how you can be asked to generate your equation given the roots. Example 4 says find the quadratic equation whose roots are this and this. So you say let s be minus 2 and s is plus 2. So minus 2 comes here, it becomes plus 2. So s plus 2 is 0. And s minus 2 is 0. When you multiply these two factors together, this is what we have. Minus 2s plus 2s is 0. You have s squared minus 4 is the least quadratic equation. Example 5. If 3 is a root of the equation s squared minus kx plus 42 is equal to 0, find the value of k and the other root of the equation. So we just say let x be 3 because it's the root of the equation. If 3 is a root of the equation, when you substitute 3 into this equation, or you replace s with 3, it will be equal to 0. So put 3. So we have 3 square minus k times 3 plus 42 is 0. So 3 square is 9 minus 3k plus 42 is 0. 9 plus 42 minus 3k comes here, becomes plus 3k. This 51 is 3k. Divide both sides by 3. You have that k is 17. Take 17 back to the equation. You have s squared minus 17x plus 42 is equal to 0. Why am I doing this? Because I'm asked to calculate the other root. So by factorization method that I have taught you, when you factorize this, you have two roots. S is 3 or 14. So 14 is the other root. Example 4b, you are given this as the root of the equation and are required to generate the quadratic equation. So you say let s be 2.5, which is 5 over 2, and s is s minus 1. This fraction is very convenient to make it a whole number. And to make this a whole number, you eliminate the denominator, which is 2. You multiply both sides by 2. What you do at the left-hand side, you do at the right-hand side. So I'll multiply x by 2. You have 2x is equal to 5 over 2 times 2. This 2 will go. You have 5. So 2x minus 5 is 0. It's a factor. And s is equal to minus 1. So x plus 1 is 0. It's another factor. So when you multiply the two of them, you have this result. So this is your practice question. You can just work on these questions. You can see them. And I want to appreciate many of you that have subscribed to my channel. You can also share it, and thank you. I'm very grateful. Have a nice day.